E.
That is Show me your tongue if you have a mouth. Okay, good. Looks like I got a lot of tongue.
which looks like everybody in here, doesn't it?
Does.
That is amazing. Okay, so there's... Now, I want somebody to participate in the next one. So, what, this is what it says. This equals love right here. But what I want is I want somebody to draw a picture of something that symbolizes love. Can you do that for me? Draw it big. Really big. Oh, yeah, perfect, perfect. All right, good job. Okay, so now we have to solve this equation. So if you think you know the answer, write it down, okay? So, something that I didn't tell you guys is we have a special guest here in our classroom today. Guess who it is? It's our principal, Miss Peggy, and here she is right now.
Yeah.
okay, so we need to move on because we've got more subjects to cover. We're going to move on to science, and here's the next question on your pop quiz. Are you ready for this? This is U plus blank equals joy. Okay. So, today we're doing science. I mean, this is part of it, it's science. So, we had, how many did this science projects? How many have them ready? Okay, if you have the time, we have time. We only need to do one today because we're in a rush. So, let's see who's first on the list today. William and Billy. You guys ready?
McDonald's! Let's go!
how you did it on the quiz. Everybody finish the quiz. Alright, let's see what you got. Tell me who got answer number one? What did you do for answer number one? Jesus! Somebody got Jesus! Good job. That is the correct answer. How many got number two? Anybody get number two? Let's see here. What did you get for number two? Jesus! Right! Good job!
Yeah.
be a disciple?
Be a disciple.
Really want to be a disciple? You know, a disciple is a student of Jesus. He's a follower of Christ. He's a pupil, someone who's instructed in a certain way. There's a lot of people who have disciples. Rock stars, movie stars, and sports stars, and philosophers, and all this whole world has people they follow. But can I tell you, the greatest person that you should ever follow is more than just a person. It's God himself, as they love Jesus. And I want to be a disciple. So that's what I'm going to be talking to you about this morning. I'm a disciple. Really want to be a disciple. Really want to put a little jingle to it. I'm a be a disciple. Really want to be a disciple. You hear that?
Yes.
All right. Maybe we're not speaking. I'm a be a disciple. Really want to be a disciple. Yeah, you can say it with me now. I'm not shy. Ready? I'm a be a disciple. Really want to be a disciple. I think we should add it to the other.
Yeah.
So it's really, really want to be a disciple. Because you really, really want to be. Okay, so say it with me. I'm a be a disciple. Really, really want to be a disciple. Like, he's really, really, really. Do you really want to?
Yeah.
Like, you want to be in the whole world?
Yeah.
No matter what happens, I want to be a disciple. I want to follow him. Amen. Yeah. So that's what we're going to be talking about today. And I need somebody that knows how to play Simon Says. Who knows how to play Simon Says? Doesn't anybody know how to play Simon Says? You're over your age now. You're over your age. All right, we're going to say yay to Simon Says. Who wants to say yay? All right, let's go ahead and everybody stand up. Oh, you should not have been I gotcha. Oh, man. Simon Says. Touch your nose. Stop hiding your hair. You can't see me, it's failing. Jump up and down. Do it! Simon says, stop hiding your head. Simon says, don't pick your nose. I know the temptation is there, but you got it. Simon says, walk in place. Okay. Simon says, take your hand off your nose. Simon says, yawn. This is so dangerous. Okay, stop reminding me. Okay, Simon says, stop. Now, if we are so on board with follow what Simon says, do you guys think we should be on board to follow what Jesus says?
Yeah.
And so what if Jesus says, let's just replace Simon with Jesus for a second. Jesus says, close your eyes. Now open your eyes and look around at everybody. And Jesus said, raise both your hands as high as you can towards the ceiling. And now, Jesus says to lift your head with your hands. And Jesus says, open your mouth and give him a great and mighty praise. Simply says, open my eyes so I can see all that you have planned for me.
open my eyes so I can be all that Jesus planned for me. And then the chorus is a lot of fun. You guys are doing this right. All right, hit it, Maestro.
Someday.
But she holds herself up to that influence. And there she goes. She's allowing all that influence to come into her mind. Let me tell you something about influence. Once it's into your mind, there's no getting it out. It becomes a part of your experience. It becomes a part of your memory. It becomes a part of you.
Someone said, oh.
And so, there's Candace. It's okay, Candace. Candace is making a decision on the type of friends that she has, right? Then also, there's... Can somebody read what this says? Music. Can music influence you? Music can influence you. Is it a good influence or a bad influence? Either way, Candace, what kind of music do you listen to? What type of influences you're allowing to come into your mind? And so, you know what Candace needs to listen to? She should be listening to some gospel music, right? She should be listening to some worship music. This is good stuff. Fill her mind and influences that are godly. It's going to be bad. All the bad influences in her life. And make sure that she's filling her mind with the right things. Somebody say, go, where do you go, Candace? Okay, what about this one? Family? Is anybody kind of like, can family influence you?
Yes. Oh, big time, dude.
That's the biggest influence. But the difference between music and friends is you don't only get to pick
your family.
It's just this job, right? And sometimes I recognize this. Sometimes you have brothers, sisters, aunts, sometimes you have a parent that may not be the best influence in your life. And yet, there it goes into your mind because that's what you experience. That's what you see. That's what you hear. That's what you know. And so, we have some influences that come to us because we choose them. And other influences just because that's the world in which we live. How about this? This is a big one, guys. She needs to learn how to pray. Sometimes she teaches her pastor. You can teach her how to pray. Give you an example. break, and ultimately you know what's going to help her and influence you, what's going to help her mind and her spirit and her behavior. And it's something that's going to be the Holy Ghost. Anybody here have the Holy Ghost?
Thomas, Mark, spread out so everybody needs to see some of the disciples.
to Bartholomew, Philip, Thomas, Matthew, James, the son of Alphaeus, he chose Judas, Simon, Judas Iscariot, he had all his disciples under him. And there came a point in Jesus' ministry, he was like, okay, you know what, guys? You've seen Jesus' cool stuff. I've taught you a lot of things. You guys have grown, you guys have come a long way. And so now I'm going to give you power. Someone say, cool, dude. I'm going to give you power, and what you're going to do is you're going to go to the whole region, and you're going to preach concerning the kingdom of God. And you're going to heal all manner of diseases, and you're going to cast out devils. Somebody says, cool, dude. And so, where's my other brothers at? They had some partners come up. They were going to be sick. All of them said, come on, come on. And so the disciples started going out, and they started preaching the things concerning the kingdom of God. There was people with all manner of diseases, and sicknesses, and problems, and they didn't go to Jesus. The disciples brought the power of Jesus to them.
Somebody say, come on, David.
So Simon Peter, he came across this lightning man. Simon Peter laid his hand on him. Said, be healed!
And
he was healed. Oh. That's awesome. And it's not like he did that. I mean, Jesus wasn't even there. He gave his disciples power. And so there was another one. Oh, it was James. He came across the man that was blind as well. That's what happened.
They came, and some were amazed, and some were amused.
Some were confounded and some confused, and they started making fun about what was going on in that other room. But Peter stood up. After one person in a room of comics said, "You know, these two people are all drunk, so bad isn't one!" Peter stood up with the 11 and said, "These men are drunk like you think they're drunk." But this is bad. He started to explain to them the things that Jesus put in it. From his teachings, that power to understand that Peter followed all those years. And guess what? We did Simon's test. We did Jesus' test. But in Acts chapter 2, in verses 38, you know what Peter said? He said, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins, and he shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost." So we do what Simon says, and from what we do what Jesus says. And Peter's a disciple of Jesus, and he says, "Repent and be baptized in the Holy Ghost." Do you think we should repent?
Yeah.
Do you think we should be baptized in Jesus' name?
Yeah.
Do you think we should receive the Holy Ghost?
Thank you.
influences in your life to this point. But I can feel that today, there's this all-powerful and conscious God that's reaching out to us and says, I choose you.
Yeah.